Ravi and Sam play football in their backyard every day. Now, there is a small problem which they face. The problem is that many times the ball hits the plants which are kept in the backyard, and as a result, they get a lot of scolding. So they decided that they will make a small area within the backyard in which they will play football. So initially they used to play in the entire backyard. They did not have any decided area. Now what they did? Well, they decided they will play football in this area, but just because they will play football in this area doesn't mean that the ball will not go to the plants. It can still hit the plants. So they decided they will make a fence on its boundary. Now the question is, how much fencing do they need to purchase to completely cover the length of this boundary? Well, that was the question. So they went to the shopkeeper, who suggested that they calculate the perimeter of this particular shape. Now they were a bit confused. What exactly is perimeter? Well, perimeter of a shape is nothing but the sum of all its sides. Now in this case, what do we have? We have a rectangle. So basically they have selected a rectangular area, isn't it? As you can see, a pair of opposite sides is longer than the other pair. So this exactly is a rectangle. So basically they need to find perimeter of a rectangle. So what do we know about perimeter? Well, perimeter is the length of a path or edge that surrounds a shape. In this case, it is a rectangle. Now in the case of rectangle, what do we know? Well, we have a pair of sides which is longer than the other pair. Now this longer pair is called the length of the rectangle, and this smaller pair is called the breadth of the rectangle. So we have length and breadth. Now opposite sides are of the same length in case of a rectangle, and that is very important to know if you want to calculate the perimeter of a rectangle. So in the case of rectangle, we call these two sides as L and these two sides as B. So L for length and B for breadth. So we have two L's, the opposite sides, and two B's, the opposite sides. Now in this case, this is the area which they have decided for playing football. And what is the length of this area? It's 10 meters. So this side is 10 meters long, and this opposite side will also be 10 meters. Now this side is 4 meters. So the opposite side will also be 4 meters. So we have 10 meters as length and 4 meters as breadth. So what will be the perimeter of this particular shape? Well, we know the length of all the sides. Now perimeter is nothing but sum of the length of all the sides, isn't it? So in this case, let's start from here. So this side is 10 meters long. So 10 meters plus this side is 4 meters. Opposite sides are of the same length. So 4 meters. Then again, this side is 10 meters. So 10 meters. And this side, as we know, it is 4 meters again. So 4 meters. So what do we get here? 10 plus 4, which is 14. 14 plus 10, which is 24. And 24 plus 4, which is 28. So The answer is 28 meters. So the perimeter of this particular area which they have decided is 28 meters. So they decided a rectangular area and the perimeter of this area is 28 meters, and this is the amount of fencing they need to purchase. So what did we see here exactly? Well, we added 10 plus 4, 10 plus 4 again. So we added length plus breadth plus length plus breadth, and this is the formula for area of a rectangle. So you add L plus B plus L plus B. Now once they were able to find the perimeter, they built a fence around this entire rectangle and they were able to play happily. So now with their knowledge of mathematics, they can play football in the backyard without damaging the plants, which is great, isn't it? Now you know how to calculate a perimeter. So I have a question here. Ravi is preparing a badminton court. Now badminton courts are rectangular, isn't it? Now he marked a rectangle on the ground of length 6 meters and breadth 4 meters. So what is the perimeter of the court? So we know that he marked a rectangle on the ground. Now the length of that rectangle is 6 meters. So this side and this side are 6 meters long. Now breadth is 4 meters. So 4 meters and 4 meters, both these sides. So can you tell me what will be the perimeter of this particular rectangle? Well, it's very simple. We know that perimeter is length plus breadth plus length plus breadth in case of a rectangle. So in this case we need to add the length and the breadth of this rectangle. So let's calculate. It will be 6 meters plus B, 4 meters plus L again, which is 6 meters, and then B again, 4 meters. 6 meters plus 4 meters is 10 meters. 10 meters plus 6 meters is 16 meters. 16 meters plus 4 meters is 20 meters. So what is the perimeter of this particular rectangle? It's 20 meters. And how did we calculate? Well, we calculated the perimeter of this rectangle by the formula L plus B plus L plus B. So whenever you need to find the perimeter, that is the length of the outer boundary of a rectangle, well, you use the formula L plus B plus L plus B. So in the case of rectangle, we have four sides. Now two of them are called length of the rectangle. So we have L and L, and two of them are called breadth of the rectangle. So we have B and B. And if we need to calculate the perimeter of rectangle, then it will be L plus B plus L plus B. Now this can also be written in a shorter form, because as you can see, you have L plus B once and then again you add L plus B. So we know that this can be shortened by using multiplication, isn't it? So we can write this as 2 into L plus B, because we are adding L plus B twice. So 2 into L plus B. So this is the formula for calculating the perimeter of the rectangle. So you can add L plus B plus L plus B, or you can simply multiply 2 into L plus B. And that is how you can calculate the perimeter of any rectangle. So now that you know how to calculate perimeter of a rectangle, can you answer this question? We can find the perimeter of a rectangle by using which of the following formula? So is it 2 into length plus breadth, length into breadth, or 4 into side? What do you think? Well, the answer is 2 into length plus breadth. So you see, any particular rectangle which you have in front of you, whatever size it is, you can always calculate the perimeter of the rectangle by using the formula 2 into length plus breadth. And what exactly is perimeter? It is the length of the outer boundary of any particular shape.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com to get all learning resources as per ICSE, CBSE, IB, Cambridge, or any other curriculum. Over 5,000 amazing lectures across maths, science, English, and social science. Our unique interactive video technology keeps you engaged, and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests. Performance analysis along with actionable feedback. Personal tutors to resolve your slightest of doubts. That's not all. You also get amazing prizes like PlayStations, iPads, watches, and many more, along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So at deltastep.com, learning is not just fun and easy, it's rewarding too. So register for free now.